One of the most important things as a devotee in the Hare Krishna movement is to know what we're doing in our lives as devotees. And the way we learn, the way we find out what we're doing as devotees is to read Srila Prabhupada's books. Prabhupada's books are full of practical instructions of the application of the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. In the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Prabhupada explained that deity worship is a practical application of philosophy. That philosophy alone is not enough. So the philosophy in the books is important, but just as important is reading the philosophy, understanding the philosophy, and practicing the philosophy. And that's been one of the constant themes that we've been hearing in the lectures and the workshops here at the ILS and in the temple classes, that we have to understand what to do and practice what we're hearing in the Srimad Bhagavatam. And I think it's very important for Grihastha devotees to use Srila Prabhupada's books as a form of context for association, to get together and to hear and read and remember about Krishna, and in this way guide themselves through their ashram, because ashram means to take shelter. And this is a real, Srila Prabhupada's books are the ultimate authority, but they're the ultimate shelter in the Kali Yuga. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it said that Lord Chaitanya, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, says that Lord Chaitanya is the ultimate shelter of all living entities. He's the Chaitanya Vaidya Mashraye. Chaitanya is a doctor who can cure the disease of the material disease of sense gratification and envy amongst all living entities. And to do that, we have to constantly hear and remind ourselves what we're doing as devotees of Krishna in the Krishna consciousness movement. So we really encourage you all to read Srila Prabhupada's books, to dive deeper into the philosophy and the pastimes of Krishna, and become cured of this material disease, the bhava rog. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna.